Hi. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Designing Adobe XD, our weekly live stream show where we just talk about how we design and build Adobe XD. So I'm the host, Talon Wadsworth. I'm the lead designer for Adobe XD, and I have no guest today. You just get me. My feelings aren't hurt. Everybody else on the team who's tuning in, I understand. A lot of pressure staying here, talking to the nice people in the chat. We'll get the guests back going next week. But today we're actually going to be trying something new. So thanks everybody for joining us. Hey everyone in the chat, Manuel, Sandia, Francisco, Heather. Well, that's Paco there, right? I always forget, man. Zach, hey everybody, thanks for joining us here on Behance. If you're over on YouTube, come say hi to us on Behance. b.net/live, and you can chat with us if you have any questions about XD. What is XD? How do I use XD? Again, I'm a good person to ask, so if you got any questions, let me know. But today we're gonna be doing something a little different, and we're gonna try something, and I haven't done this in a while, so I might be a little rusty, but today I'm gonna share a case study with you in how we design features in XD. And we're gonna be talking about one of the most sort of the most requested, most hotly contested features in XD, layers. And I know everybody has their own feelings, their own complicated relationship with layers, whether that's in Photoshop or Illustrator or any of the design tools that you've known and loved. Layers are a very, it's complicated, right? I don't think anybody really loves layers. Maybe they do. Hey, Aditya, thanks for joining in. And Sandia, thanks for joining us there in the middle of the night. In India. I was just in Bangalore, had a great time in Bangalore. Hey to everybody who's there in India tuning in. So today, as I said, we're gonna break down and really talk about like how we approach designing features in XD. Again, there might be, you know, when we're out there and we're using these tools or these services, you know, and you come across some idea and you're like, oh, I think, I wish that this tool had this thing, whatever it is. And you know, of course, with Twitter and everything, there's really easy ways to kind of reach out to those teams and kind of, you know, ask. But, you know, one that team could then just take that question or that request and just go and implement it. But again, like, we like to try and figure out why. Why should we put in a tool like layers or a feature like layers? Where does it fit within a designer's workflow? And so I'm going to share some of our thinking around that today. So hey to everybody who's joining us. We're going to go and kick things off today. Again, this is going to be a little different format for us. So let's see how it goes. So again, apologies ahead of time. I might be a little rusty, but let's dig into it. Let's talk about how we design new features for XD. Today, we're really going to be focusing on layers. You know, layers, again, we have them, we know them, we love them in XD today, but if you can believe it, there was a time when XD did not have layers, which seems really crazy. It's kind of hard to think back that long ago now. But yeah, we actually launched XD without layers. So this was basically the most asked question back when we originally launched XD as Project Comet. Now said a little over 2 years ago when we launched Project Comet. Whenever I would tell anyone that I was the lead designer for XD, this was their first question. Again, because we didn't have them, and I can't say I wasn't expecting this, but again, people really miss layers. They were like, I can't use XD until there are layers. And so, you know, my question was, why? Like, why do you need layers? I was really interested because I gotta say, I am not a layers. I don't like layers. I keep them closed for a long time. I loved working in Keynote that didn't have layers. And I really felt strongly like if the tool's doing its job, you know, why do you need layers? So, you know, like that was the question I really was interested in. And again, like, I really wanted to know why people needed layers, but of course that question was a little rhetorical. Tiffany, you love layers. I again, my relationship with layers is a little complicated. But of course, you know, like we're XD and we're Adobe and we are layers. Like Adobe is the company that has, of course, you know, Photoshop and Illustrator, and layers are a fundamental part of those workflows inside those apps. But again, we really wanted to figure out like, okay, what are layers? Let's really go dive in and let's really get to the bottom of, you know, what layers are, you know, in the tools that people have loved in the past. And so when we were kicking off this investigation, again, really trying to address this question that designers had for us, you know, we really started looking at our own work and how we use layers and how we use layers in this case inside of Illustrator. So this was actually one of my own documents inside of Illustrator. And as you can see, I'm really bad at layers. Again, like there's just a lot of information going on here. This is even like all of the layers. These are just a small sort of like snippet of those layers. Again, and I probably haven't named a lot of these. Again, you can see they have very generic names. Doesn't feel very useful, right? So this was not a great example of layers. Hey everyone joining us. We had a couple questions. Wanted to sort of start by answering Emma's question. Emma, XD's function within Adobe, we really are the tool for UX, UI design, and for building interactive prototypes. Today we're talking about how we added layers into XD. So this was, you know, as we went to do in every, as we talked about a couple weeks ago with Lindsay Wallace, every great design effort really starts with research, building a foundation of knowledge. So we really were looking at like, how do people use layers today? And so we were looking at our own files. I reached out to other designers I knew and actually kind of opened up their files and just saw how they were using layers. This is actually a Photoshop design inside of Photoshop, you know, very, very, very meta, very Inception-like, right? So we saw that there's a lot going on here. There are a lot of symbols. There are a lot of masks happening here, right? And things are pretty complicated here. And some people were actually doing, again, as these people kind of grew with these products and really started to fit them into workflows, you know, people would come up with ways in which to stay very organized, and labeling became very important. And this is a file from one of our designers on the icon team here at Adobe. And very, a lot of structure here, a lot of thought put into how these layers are organized. I'm like, okay, people, that's pretty interesting. They have very specific naming conventions here. You can see them labeling and doing dividers. Right, so people are doing a lot with layers, it seems like. And again, like things get crazy really fast in layers. And that was probably the biggest thing that I always felt was, you know, as you're working and designing, you know, layers felt like another thing that you were worried about. That you were worried about labeling and managing. And so again, there's a lot going on here. And this was, I actually like to share this here, because back when we were first starting XD, this was the very first design for XD's UI. And this was done actually in Keynote. I actually designed the very first UI for XD in Keynote. And as you can see, it's very innocent. It's very pristine. There's not really a lot going on here. And you know, I was really struggling with like, you know, why I don't want to just add one of those big long panels with a bunch of information, you know, into this. Like I don't know, it just felt like it was gonna mess it up. you know, so again, like this was kind of where we were starting from. Do we want to jump, you know, into this? You know, yeah, it didn't feel like that was, we were just going to translate the one-to-one from, you know, Photoshop and Illustrator into XD. You know, and again, some layers, as we saw, were better than others, right? Well, I mean, it looked very basic because there wasn't a lot there. We wanted to keep it very simple, very focused, you know? And so, you know, layers, and some people manage layers better than others. You know, some people do a lot of organization, and it kind of helps them as they build up very complex files, and some people are better at that than others. Right, here, very minimalist layers panel here in this file. Someone's very organized in this one. Right, so at the time we were really looking at all these examples, and then we came across this one. And this came from some research from the Photoshop team, and this is crazy. I mean, you look at this, and you're coming into this cold. I hope the designer who designed this knew what was going on, because wow, like there's a lot going on here. You know, there's not just layers, but then there are layer comps, right? There's all, I mean, I don't even know how you make sense of something like this. Right? And yeah, so, you know, basically the sense of layers at the time as we were looking at it was like, wow, this is a hot mess. Like, how do we ever break this down and figure out how to pull in layers and all the functionality that people expect from Photoshop and Illustrator, for any tool that has layers in it? How do we make sure that, like, you know, we can launch a feature like layers with all of those workflows in mind? It seemed like a really huge task. Of course, our next part of our research was we went to the internet and we figured out, okay, somebody has had to solve this, right? So when we went out and I just searched for Photoshop layer management on Google, like, how are people doing this? What are the best practices? There were 563,000 results for Photoshop layer management on Google, which, again, so there are clearly no agreed upon way to do this. Everybody was doing it a little differently. So this was gonna be, we weren't gonna really go sift through this. It seemed like maybe a little too much. So rather than just sort of looking at files and sort of opening them cold and seeing the layers panel, right? Like, we actually now went back to these designers and we asked them directly, like, how are you using layers? We really wanted to know. And so we basically got into it. And these were some of the responses that we got for how designers use layers. It's all, I mean, wow. It, I mean, yeah, grouping, right, Emma? Like, they use it to, you know, for selecting, they name them, they use them for red lines. Some people do scripting. You know, you'll see some of the other Easter eggs that I put into this slide. You know, maybe Voldemort's Horcrux is a layer. I don't know. But basically, like this was the response, and this was not even like these are the big ones, the ones that we felt like made a lot of sense. And again, like, they're kind of all over. Again, it's just showing that, like, when we were talking to designers directly, is that everybody was using layers in a little bit different way. So again, how are we gonna build a feature that supported all of this? Seems pretty crazy. Brandacity, like, I'm glad that you're one of those organized people, because me, I usually have to then, you know, I was usually going back and organizing, like, after the fact, like, after I was designing, and, like, good luck figuring out my file, whether it's Photoshop or Illustrator. So, yeah, some of us are better at this than others. I always like a good meme. So again, like, those questions, like, wow, we got a ton of responses and it's a very overwhelming list. So where do we start? You know, like, how are we going to start designing a feature like layers when people use them for so many different things? Well, during those interviews where we were talking to users about their workflows and talking to them about how they use and build, you know, layers and, you know, bring them into their workflows, I really loved kind of just more of these, like, statements that came kind of, you know, just as they were talking again about their relationship with layers. And these were some of my favorite quotes from those early interviews. You know, right? Layers don't matter until they matter, right? Like, they're invisible until I actually need them to do something, right? The question, and the people were saying, you know, we want them to be as simple as possible and no simpler, right? Like, they need a core set of functionality. It needs to help me do my work better. And if I can't do that, then that was weird. Sorry, a little sound here in our studio that kind of threw me off. Right? They really want it to be easy to use, right? And of course, this one, I used to name layers, but then I started to feel like I was only creating more work for myself. Again, that was one of the things we really wanted to stay away from when designing a feature for XD. Was just creating more work, creating more management, more things for you to do, right? You should be focused on designing, not on managing your layers, right? So kind of the next step after kind of those early interviews as we went and we started to design and we started to prototype. We started to sort of take all of that information and really try to synthesize it into a plan, into something that we felt like we could go and tackle, you know, without spending years on, you know, making layers. Everything it is, it's in Photoshop. I mean, that took a long time for Photoshop to get there, and we were brand new. We wanted to get a feature out there that people felt like they could use and really integrate into their workflows in a really seamless way. So we started by prototyping. So, you know, creating many ideas and then trying to validate those ideas as we went. Photoshop layers in Photoshop. Emma in the chat was just saying that she's not perfect with it, even though she's like really good at Photoshop. Everybody, it's really tough. So one of the first things we did is we took that big long list that I shared and we started to break it down into tasks that happen at different phases in a designer's workflow. So we had, some of those actions that people were saying they did with layers were done in a much more ad hoc way. They were done in while they were designing things, they were very transitory. And they had actions they were doing that fit into a more deliberate category where they were making really clear choices to help them as their file grew in complexity. And then they had things that they were doing that really were more about management or really more about communication, both for myself as a designer and for my team. And so we took some of those core sets of actions that people were doing, and we organized them into these different phases of the workflow, right? So, you had things that were much more ad hoc, things that I always need to be doing while I'm designing with vector software. I need to lock and unlock things very quickly, hide show things, move things up and down in sort of the Z order hierarchy. And then I had things that I did that were much more deliberate, right? Emma mentioned grouping or brandacity, right? Like there are things that I did to create some hierarchies so that I could start, again, managing big blocks of my design. And I started labeling, to stay a little organized as my file grows in complexity. It'll save me some time later, right? And then there are those actions that we all do when, right, our file's probably almost done, and now we need to do some level of management, right? This is things that are really about us communicating through our files to, say, our developer, or maybe a teammate, another designer, or to, our product team, right? This really helps other people, when they come into the file, really understand what's going on, right? And so we kind of took, again, that big, long list, and we just edited it down and really fit them within these different parts of a designer's workflow. And this really helped us sort of guide some of our first explorations, right, around layers. And our biggest question was really like, well, what if layers were smarter? What if layers actually helped you during these different phases of your workflow? What would that look like? That was something that really interested us, was, again, rather than this big long list of all the objects and all the layers on all of my artboards or pages, what if layers were smarter? What if they knew kind of where you were in your workflow? What if they knew where you were in the location of the file? What would that start to look like? Thanks for everybody who's joining us now. Again, I'm doing a little more kind of linear presentation today, a little case study in how we designed a feature in XD. If you're over on YouTube, come say hi to us in the Behance chat over here on bean.net/live. And again, try and answer as many questions as possible as we're walking through this. And let me know. Let me know what you think. Let me know how you use layers. All right, so this was our fundamental question that we asked when we started designing this feature. It's like, bringing layers, into XD, right? What if they were smarter? So this is, I gotta say, I pulled this out this morning. This is, this could be one of the earliest production-ready designs we ever did in a build of XD. There was not a lot of functionality, but I could design this. I designed this in a very, very early working production build of XD. It's one of the very first designs I ever did in XD full time. And the idea here was, and you'll see these little dots pop up here on the side of the artboard, was that, again, like, what if layers were much more contextual? What if they weren't hidden in a panel, but actually available and sort of visible to you while you were working on the canvas in XD? Right? So I've selected, in this example, I've selected that little block of content. And now you can see these little dots that were actually representing layers now show up alongside the artboard. Not in a panel, not in somewhere else on the screen, but right in line with that. And as I select other layers, again, it sort of shows these different dots highlighting. And maybe I could actually interact with those and actually, again, maybe hover over and see the layer title. And I could maybe, hide it or show it or rearrange those. Again, really pushing on, again, like, what are layers for? And in this one, this was really focused on a lot of those ad hoc actions, again, rearranging, locking, hiding, showing, right? So these are things that, again, this was kind of guiding some of those early, those thinking was kind of guiding some of these early prototypes we were creating. Maybe this is a little too minimal, and we quickly moved on from this, but I just thought this was really fun to share some of these early designs, you know, of XD inside of an early build of XD. It's really cool. Yeah, MLA, you know, separating different edits. I'm making a photo. I mean, in Photoshop, layers are again are very complex, and keeping kind of past versions. Those are all really great uses of layers. And so here's kind of another study where I've gone back to a panel. I think we all kind of agreed when I got feedback from the team that layers really didn't belong kind of on canvas. That I have a lot going on already. But layers were something that felt like it was okay to have in maybe in a panel. Hey, Matthias, how's it going, man? Good to see you on here. We're talking about how we design layers in XD today. This is an early motion prototype that we did, showing maybe you a new position for layers. So this kind of integrated panel that kind of shifted the toolbar. So again, we kind of went back to maybe a more panel-based approach, again, because we thought the actions that you need to do there, that you could do them not, you didn't want to do them on canvas. You still wanted to see, you know, this list of objects that you could go and manage on their own. So this is one of those early prototypes for that. And it's a little bit different variation, a little motion study. Again, doing a lot of this, really again, trying to work very quickly, really test our ideas, get a lot of feedback. And then showing some of the interactions, again, sort of diving into some of the things that you would actually need to do with layers. And this actually showed creating a master object. And also looking at, again, really being inspired, I was definitely inspired by like mobile UI at the time, showing a lot of cool interactions happening directly on the object, showing the resulting action of something that I was doing on screen, you know, in the layers panel. Again, still trying to keep it feeling very simple, very focused. So that was a cool one. What we kind of landed on that kind of guided a lot of those early efforts that we kind of came to that we got really excited by was this concept that we called local layers. And the idea was, you know, what if the layers panel only showed you what you need when you needed it? And it was responsive to you and to your design as you were working. And so this was a more sort of fleshed out, fully very complex prototype that we created. And you can see this layers panel on the right-hand side. And as I'm stopping, and I'm gonna pause this for a second, as I'm actually selecting objects, things are displaying in the layers panel, but only when I'm working on them. And then it's showing me the things that are selected, and those are highlighted in the kind of the darker sort of highlight, and they're sort of all left aligned here. Like, those are my selected objects. And what this was showing me was a preview of objects that were near or around or underneath the things that I had selected. So very contextual. This layers, the information that was displaying in this layers panel was really based on your actions. And it was showing you, again, just those layers that you needed while you were working on that particular artboard, right? And this is only showing you layers on that left-hand artboard. Right. Let's see if this will play again. All right, here it goes. So as I select more, the layers panel is actually revealing more information. All right, I'm grouping, and I'm seeing these nice little motion studies. All right, showing the drag and drop into groups, and groups are auto expanding. There's a lot of really fun stuff happening here. So Robert, thanks for the being new to XD. Thanks for your question. Does not support video or animation or GIFs yet, but it's something the team is actively working on. So I really loved this prototype. And actually, see, the other little detail I like here was that, I wanted to be able to, say, export very quickly any of my selections. And so you see that little, as I'm selecting things, that little download icon shows up. And then I can just quickly export some versions of that for my developer if I needed to. All right, and this is very contextual. Again, the layers panel was blank until you started working. And that seemed like kind of a radical concept. It seemed like something like, again, that a lot of people had a lot of strong feelings about as I started showed this to colleagues internally. And there's a lot of debate about this. And, you know, again, this is just a design prototype. Again, we haven't really moved into code yet, and we're really trying to answer a lot of these questions again before we go and commit some development time to this feature. So, again, something that we really hadn't done up to that point with design prototypes is we actually went and we actually posted this online. We had launched the Project Comet beta. And what we did was we actually posted this video on our user voice forum. And this is a forum that we were using from some of our earliest private and public releases for XD. And this is a place where people could go and they could actually suggest features for us to work on. And they could vote on those features. And it's still active today. So if you go to adobexd.uservoice.com, you can still go and suggest features and go and vote on that for us. And we actually put this design prototype out there, and we actually were looking for designers to give us feedback. And the response kind of blew us away from that video of the local layers concept. And we got a ton of amazing feedback. I think we got 10 or 12 pages on user voice of feedback. And this was really amazing. You know, designers, again, writing, you know, again, posts like this in response to the video. And I can't tell you how you know, grateful we were as a team to sort of see people engaging with XD, you know, from the earliest betas and builds, and, you know, responding to a design prototype, again, just a concept, you know, again, really asking for feedback and asking for that direct collaboration with the design community. And we got a ton of just amazing responses. And I gotta say, like, these responses really guided that concept, that local layers concept, into the layers panel as it is today in XD. So once we got that feedback, we felt very confident that layers should be very contextual. Again, should really display information that is easy to sort of follow, easy to use. And so this is actually a video now of layers working in XD today. And again, it's very contextual. It's only showing you the layers for the artboard that you're actively working on. But again, sort of keeping that information very focused. Again, if you're, you know, if you're working on one artboard, why do you care about the layers that are on an artboard, you know, another part of the screen that's not even visible at the time? So you don't have to keep scrolling through this long list that you're seeing only the things that matter to you when they matter. So I think we really kept a lot of that local layers flavor into the final build of XD. And it also doubles as navigation. I don't know, this is kind of a little hidden gem, but if you open up that layers panel and you see all your artboards, you can actually use that to navigate through to anywhere in the canvas. And you'll see this sort of in this video that I took where it kind of zooms out and you're seeing all the artboards. And when you double click on an artboard, it'll actually take you right to that artboard and you can immediately start working. So this is, again, kind of the story of kind of where we're at today. And this story is not done. That's what's kind of amazing about working on this product and on this team is that, you know, we release monthly builds. And for those of us who've been with us since the beta, Emma and others, they've seen XD develop. And, you know, our goal with XD is to not wait, not just sit on features and not wait for some big release, but actually continually sort of, again, respond to requests. I really think very deeply about user problems, designer problems that they're having, and figure out really, really great ways to go and solve those problems. And so this has just kind of been kind of one case study in how we kind of approach designing any feature in XD. And so if you go and you make a request on the user voice forum, rest assured that this is the process that how we approach any request and any feature request, is we really try and look for, again, what is a designer looking to do? And we're really assessing, is that the right feature for them to go and do that? Is that, again, something that we can rely on kind of other examples, or is that something we want to go and innovate on and really get to the heart of, again, those challenges and problems that designers are having? And it's sharing that with all of you and getting your feedback. So I think we're almost done with our stream today. Again, a little different format. Thank you all for sort of hanging with me today and letting me take you through this case study. And again, we'll be back to share more. If this is something you guys really like, let me know. We'll be back with a guest next week. Next week, we're going to be with my good friend Sean Cheris, and we're going to be talking about how we use our own design system here at Adobe to design Adobe XD. So thank you all for chatting with us. And if you have any questions, hit me up on Twitter, at Mr. Talon. And we'll be back next week, same time on Friday. Thanks, everybody.